But why? And why now?
There is a convergence of perceived threats.
Turns out, we're in a perfect storm. Solar flares, Mayan calendars, celestial crashes. I'm Anne-Marie McDonald, and this Doc Zone looks deep inside Apocalypse 2012. On mountaintops and in secret caves.
There's only one way in, surrounded by mountains.
In the concrete relics of the Cold War.
This infrastructure would cost about $60 million.
And in bunkers deep underground, they're preparing for the worst.
Wow, looks fantastic.
Like survivors on a global reality show. But it's not a game, and there won't be any prizes at the end. They're building blast shelters.
If everyone that wants to buy one had one, we'd have this sold three times over.
Stashing supplies for it.
This is four man years worth of food.
And loading their weapons for it.
Have a means of protection to show them that you mean business.
A global community of survivalists says it's the end of the world as we know it.
It will happen. There is no doubt about this.
Be prepared or die. Is it fear alone at work here? Or are they right to be scared?
An estimated 3,000 people gave up their former lifestyles to follow the prophet's vision to Paradise Valley.
Call it the apocalypse, or the rapture, or just doomsday. The idea of the end is as old as the ages. Prophets over the centuries have claimed to see it coming.
I am God.
The kingdom of God is the consciousness of God.
With a variety of different expiry dates and some version of the Almighty pulling the plug in a catastrophic finale. But the trouble brewing this time around is a kind of perfect storm created by ancient Maya prophecy and dire scientific predictions, all fueled by the World Wide Web.
We're seeing that these apocalyptic ideas have migrated to more secular context. They've migrated away from being localized to being more global. They've become less community-based, more kind of networked phenomenon stretching out around the world.
The believers are connected by nearly 400 million internet sites devoted to perpetuating fears about Apocalypse 2012.
It's a big cultural phenomenon. It's something that is grabbing people's imaginations. What I find doubtful is that knowledge of 2012 would be as widespread as it is without the internet.
Most of the sites predict the exact date of destruction in 2012 will be December 21st. That's because it's the last day marked by the ancient Mayas on what's called the Long Count calendar.
2012 is very fatalistic because it's not about a war of good and evil. It's just kind of an event that's gonna happen, right? And there's nothing we can do about it. It's just like a clock that's finally gonna wind down.
And since young people are the biggest internet consumers, they're highly susceptible. At Holy Cross High School in Woodbridge, Canada, students in the graduating art class have put their darkest fears about that date on display.
You know, obviously, it's something that I'm thinking about heavily because life and death is very serious.
Scientists have predicted this. So once they say scientists, it becomes more convincing.
They did find facts and they found, things that prove it.
There's a mystery surrounding the year 2012. It's then when many people believe that the world will undergo a major change.
But we have to be prepared for a solar tsunami.
Many believe 2012 is the year the world changes.
आंखों से नींद खुल जाएगी.
Earthquake आ सकता है या फिर communication systems fail हो सकते हैं.
Doom and gloom, fear and disaster, hot buttons guaranteed to grab headlines. And right now, there's a very receptive audience.
We live in times of high anxiety. There's no question about that. Some of that, I think, is because we have access to so much information.
There are hundreds of books and dozens of documentaries, all with their own 2012 theories.
People want to know, what's all of this buzz that's going on? I hadn't heard of 2012, but now I know. And now that I know, it makes me very anxious and worried, and I want to find out more about it. But it's very difficult to tell what's real and what's fabricated these days.
For the last 2 years, I've been answering hundreds of questions from the public about 2012 and the supposed threat to Earth. And so now I want to take a chance to talk to some of you more directly.
At the NASA Science Space Program, Dr. David Morrison believes the scientific veneer attached to all the apocalyptic predictions is pure bunk.
Every few years in recent history, there has been some threat that's come up of the end of the world, like Y2K. This one seems to be worse because at least the people who write to me are genuinely fearful. This isn't just a possibility, they're almost certain. I have had young people threaten suicide. I've had women talk about killing themselves and their children. There is a convergence of perceived threats.
The first threat arises from a phantom planet called Nibiru that will either crash into us or pitch Earth out of its orbit.
The original fear was of a planet, or some say a brown dwarf, called Nibiru, that supposedly was discovered by the ancient Sumerians and comes by every 3,600 years.
Then there are the sun storms, which were predicted to peak in 2012, in what's called a solar maximum, bombarding Earth with solar flares or radiation.
It's very difficult to predict specific solar flares or even to know when the next sunspot maximum is. In any case, there's nothing about the sun that threatens people.
But the doomsayers argue the sun will become a threat to Earth because of holes in the magnetic field that acts as a kind of protective shield.
It's my understanding that these variations in the magnetosphere that have been discovered recently have no implications in terms of a greater threat.
Okay, then how about this scenario? The Earth's magnetic poles suddenly flip, which happens every 300,000 or 400,000 years. Or there's a change in the inner core causing the planet to spin in reverse.
If the magnetic pole should flip, I doubt if it would have any effect on us on Earth. As far as the Earth changing direction, that's never happened.
But if it does happen, the believers predict landslides, volcanic eruptions, and tidal waves, cutting off power, threatening the food supply, and sparking civil war.
I call this cosmophobia. One thing after another, it's almost as though whenever they hear a news flash or read about some new discovery, the first thing that comes to their mind is, will it hurt me? Is it going to destroy the Earth?
From the City of Angels off the Pacific Ocean, good morning, good evening, wherever you may be. I'm George Norrie, and this is Coast to Coast AM. My motto tonight is be prepared, not scared. West of the Rockies, you're up.
I did a report for the Joint Chiefs of Staff. Basically, we're kind of screwed.
George Norrie is the host of the most popular late-night radio show in North America called Coast to Coast.
Our topic is 2012. You are on the air.
His listeners already buy into the 2012 prophecy, so Norrie is preaching to the choir. But he's always ready to ratchet up the stakes.
The 2012 movement continues to grow. If I could put up a shingle at my office and just say, psychiatrist, I would make $1 zillion. People are always asking me, what do you think? Are we going to get through it? What can I do? And, you know, I simply try to tell them, we are all in this together, and eventually we're going to get through it together. It's going to be a rough road. I'm not trying to kid anybody. I don't want to sugarcoat this. We are going to have some hills and valleys. This is going to be a roller coaster ride you had better strap yourself in for.
But whatever the thoughts or theories, everyone hopes it'll turn out okay in the end. And that's what Hollywood delivers, the happy ending.
In a certain sense, we live in a very apocalyptic culture. People want the cathartic experience of feeling the feelings that come with a cosmic ending to things, right? And of watching a few heroic figures struggle to survive in the circumstance.
But at the red carpet launch of the movie 2012, even the heroes weren't too sure about the ending.
So people shouldn't be fearful.
Well, I don't know, you know? I mean, if they want to listen to me, they shouldn't. What do I know?
The movie features an orgy of catastrophic destruction.
I read a lot of books about it, and some of these books really scared me. It really, really scared me. There was this one book called Apocalypse 2012, which really scared me.
The man who wrote Apocalypse 2012 is Lawrence Joseph. In Hollywood, he's called a science writer.
I have put together really undeniable scientific evidence that our way of life is threatened seriously and soon.